Hey everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part one of this video series, we introduced the OpenClip workflow for external versioning management within the Flame products. This included a brief discussion about the OpenClip XML files, which form the basis of the OpenClip workflow. Being able to easily create the OpenClip metadata files when importing or even exporting media from Flame gives you complete control of the master timelines, and you can choose and update the different versions of the media as they are externally generated from other third-party applications. This is great pipeline functionality if you collaborate with others within your facility and finish your productions in the Flame products. The rest of this video series will guide you through the different key stages when using the OpenClip workflow in the Flame 2018.2 update. So you'll first start off with importing media as an OpenClip. If you'd like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. Alternatively, if you are watching the podcast version of this video, then type the displayed link in your favorite web browser. Now, everything to do with importing and exporting in the Flame products is always performed in the Media Hub. Please ensure you are looking in this view. In the file browser, navigate to the root folder of the downloaded media. Ignore the new external versions directory for now. Go into the media folder and you will find three folders containing the media for the Conform. Digging into any of these directories, you will eventually find the media. This can be any media you're starting with, and it can be image sequences or movie files. In our case, this is the original camera media before VFX and grading. Now, in order to facilitate versioning using the OpenClip workflow, you don't want to import the media directly. Instead, you'll use an XML OpenClip to reference the media. Later, you'll be able to update the version media through the OpenClip without touching the original media, as well as avoid going through the process of unlinking and relinking media. So to make an OpenClip, select the media and call up the contextual menu. Here you will be able to create an OpenClip. The OpenClip creator appears, and there are a variety of settings which we'll get to in a moment. What I do want to point out before you go any further is that you're about to create an OpenClip for a single clip. If you're just working on a single shot, then this is perfectly fine. But what if this was part of a Conform and you want to create OpenClips for every shot or a bunch of shots? So instead, go back up to the root of the media folder. If all the media was in one directory, you could just do a multi-selection and create the OpenClips. If you're working within a folder structure like this, just click Scan Subdirectories to expose all the media within the subfolders. So here are the shots that will be part of the Conform. Now multi-select the clips with either Ctrl-click or Shift-select and call up the contextual menu again. Choose Create OpenClip. The OpenClip creator appears again, and this time, whatever is part of the multi-selection will be affected by the OpenClip creator. Now, the first decision you have to make when creating an OpenClip is what type of OpenClip you need for the selection. Now, there are quite a few types, but to begin with, you are going to choose the single version type. This setting will create an OpenClip per file in the selection. Each shot will get its own OpenClip with a single entry pointing to the original media. The remaining OpenClip types will be discussed in later videos. In the File tab, you'll see all the selected files under the Input Files section. Under the Output, the file name is grayed out. This happens because using multi-selection with the single type settings creates an OpenClip per file in the selection. So each OpenClip's name will be based on the media's file name. Switching to the Metadata tab, you can add additional metadata such as naming the open clip within Flame, setting a source and tape name if necessary, and finally, you can add a comment to the open clips. As an additional tip, this comment will be visible as a note in batch to pass on any extra information. Finally, you need to decide where to create the open clips. This is purely down to you and your production pipeline. In the case of this example, open the browser and navigate to the root folder of the downloaded media. Just create a new directory and call it Open Clips. As I said, the Open Clips could be with the media or anywhere you choose for them. Go into the folder and click Open. Next, click Create. In the file browser, navigate to the root directory of the downloaded media and refresh the window. Now go inside the Open Clips folder. Here you will find the three open clips, and to verify this, double-click on any clip to call up the preview window. Note that the format is set to MIO clip, and if you click on the Versions tab, you will find one version in the file. Now you treat the open clips like regular clips in the Flame products. The open clips will read all the metadata from the original media, so you can edit with these clips, conform them in a sequence, use them in VFX, and you should have the exact same experience as before. The only difference is that as external versions of the media are delivered, you can update the open clip, and this can be reflected in the Flame products. So let's quickly conform these clips into a sequence. Switch to the Conform view. Right-click and choose to load an XML AAF or EDL. In the file browser, navigate to the AAF directory. Select the AAF file and press Import. So this is the unlinked sequence in the Conform view. Now, very importantly, you don't have to import the open clips beforehand in order to use them with the Conform. I mean, you can if you want to, but like I said earlier, you treat open clips like regular clips. So click the search location to find the open clips. In the browser, navigate to the Open Clips folder. Now, if you had not created the open clips or forgotten to do that earlier, you can do it here in this browser. The contextual menus will still work here, so you don't have to start in the Media Hub and then come to Conform. Choose the folder and click Set. If the media is not matched, call up the Match Criteria window and set the match criteria to file name and source timecode. The open clips should now be matching their respective entries in the sequence. Click Link Sources. The video segments are now linked to the open clips. Looking at the audio tracks, they remain unlinked. The reason for this is that the current open clip creator only creates open clips that reference the video media. It is possible to edit the open clips externally in a text editor and add the additional audio tracks, but that is not for everyone. The other thing to consider is that you probably won't be versioning the audio in Flame anyway. The audio might have been recorded separately or is part of the movie files media. So the suggested workflow in this case is just to link the audio to its original media and reference the video to the open clips. To finish this off, click the search location again and navigate to the root of the original media. Select the media folder and click Set. All the audio sources should be found. To avoid clip duplication in the sources reel, disable Save Sources. Now click Link Sources. Switch to the timeline view and call up the player. Scrubbing through the sequence, everything appears as normal as you would expect. However, if you select any of the video segments, you will notice a clip version section in the effects bar. Since you're using the single type open clip that only references the original version of the media, these options don't do very much for the moment. So now you've approached a point within the open clip workflow where you may already have the versioned media, or you're about to start receiving the versioned media, which is probably more likely. So here is a brief synopsis of the two different open clip types that will be mentioned in the next video. The multi-version open clip deals with versioned media that already exists. In other words, if your versioned media has already been supplied, you can update to multi-version open clips that point directly to the files on your hard drive. This contrasts with the pattern open clip, which acts as a placeholder for media. In other words, if you don't have the versioned media yet, but you want to set up the open clip workflow, the pattern open clip can scan a folder structure for any incoming media. And as versioned media is deposited in the structure, the new versions automatically update in the Flame products. We'll mainly focus on this open clip type in the upcoming videos. Don't forget to also check out the other enhancements, workflows, and features to the Flame 2018.2 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.